Welcome back to Big Mouth, and fancy seeing you here in a very good morning. Outside here in Cyprus, it's scary windy, it's raining, so I need you lot to make me feel safe. But we're not going to feel very safe because we're going to talk about someone very, very scary. Split is the best film I've seen in the past 20 years. Why did I take so long to watch this film? Why did I resist watching this film? I'm an idiot, right? It's so funny, isn't it? You know, we hear about these bloggers and critics literally masturbating about the MCU in Infinity War. When were they talking about this film? One of the best films ever made. James McAvoy. Let's talk about James McAvoy again. They all went mad about Heath Ledger after he died, of course, right? As the Joker, and it was a fantastic performance. Nobody can deny that. It's brilliant. I love DC, and I'm glad he gave us a fantastic Joker. But what McAvoy does in this film is sensational. Now, anyone who's spoken to Jimmy McAvoy knows he is a tremendous guy. He really is. Big personality, lovely guy. You see him smile, you just want to give him a cuddle. How did he do this? He did this because he's a talented actor. And no surprise, he was, you know, he was trained classically in the UK. Of course, James is Scottish. So really, what this film, right, is about Kevin, right, who's got these multiple personalities. He's seen a psychiatrist, but it's what happens is at the start of this film, the, you know, these three girls get abducted. I'm not sure if it's Kevin who abducts them. You'll have to tell me that. Or if it's one of the other personalities. But anyway, he abducts his three girls. Now, what happens is one of these girls, which is Casey, played by Casey. No, let me start again. One of these girls, which is the main character in this film, along with James McAvoy's character, is Casey Cook. Now, what happens at the start of this film, there's these two really attractive young girls. So the father comes to pick up his daughter. So he asks this girl, Casey, to come along. And he's actually standing there. He's telling his daughter, we're not leaving until her parents come. But they never come. So what happens is she agrees. She takes a while to agree, but she agrees. So then that's when it happens. He gets knocked over the head or sprayed with that kind of sleeping gas that he seems to have. And then they go into this underground thing where they're prisoners. And then it really does begin. So that's when you start seeing backflashes from Casey's childhood, where she seems to be around her Uncle John, who clearly is abusing her in some way. I'm assuming sexually, but I'm not too sure. So the performance of Anna Taylor-Joy, again, which wasn't spoken about that much. This film was spoken about in glowing terms, don't get me wrong. But not in the glowing terms of Infinity War. It's an absolute joke. Anyway, so this story is about Casey. I'm shit with names, so I have to keep referring to my phone that I'm looking at right now. But yeah, so the performance by her is brilliant. And this is Casey's and Kevin's story. But I want to talk about something because, again, we've given so much gravitas to Thanos in Infinity War, but ultimately, Thanos is a computer-generated image. James McAvoy is playing all these different fucking personalities by his own acting talent. No Oscar. Why? Why no Oscar? No Oscar nomination. What he did was amazing. I've never seen that on a film before, but still no fucking recognition because a Mickey Mouse logo didn't come before his film. Now, let me calm down and talk about M. Night Shyamalan, who plays a role in this film as well. Look, this man is a genius. Yes, he's made a couple of duds. Yes, so what? You can't make an omelette without breaking a few eggs. So that doesn't make him a bad creative. M. Night Shyamalan, right, is one of the best creatives I've ever come across in the industry. Damn it. After seeing Split, desperate for him to write and direct his very own DCEU movie. Please make it happen. Please, please, please. The man is a genius. And what he's achieved in this film is genius. You can't get anything out of any actor without a great director. Let's not forget who gets his performance out of Jimmy McAvoy. It's M. Night Shyamalan, right? M. Night Shyamalan. What? I don't want to hear a bad word. It's funny, you lot keep on saying, Kevin Feige's a genius. Put him next to M. Night Shyamalan. Still a genius? I don't think so. I am so impressed by this film. And again, I don't know why I didn't watch it. The fear he creates in this film, I mean, when the beast is squeezing the psychiatrist, it's just phenomenally scary for me and amazing. And you just hope he's not going to kill her. But he does. And when he gets back to Kevin, he looks around and says, what's happened? What have I done? And then he realizes what's happened. It's just a great performance. Not a great, listen, I'm underselling this by calling it great. It's not a great performance. It's an astounding performance, right? It's one of the best performances I've seen in film. It's amazing. What is achieved in this film is amazing and powerful. And, you know, I know when a film's affected me because when it's finishing, its music is still beating inside of my head. This was something extremely special. Many, many years ago, M. Night Shyamalan gave us Unbreakable. It was a brilliant film with a brilliant twist on the superhero genre before superheroes were actually fashionable. Amazing. And now he's about to complete his trilogy with Glass Movie, because Split and Glass Movie are a continuation of Unbreakable. And of course, at the end of Split, we see Bruce Willis. When they're on the news talking about Split, and they say, yeah, they called someone else a name. Oh, and then Bruce Willis is at the end of the bar and he goes, Mr. Glass. Brilliant. So I can't wait. You know, it's funny as well because you've got this film coming out, which is a part of a trilogy. Now, everyone's saying that Avengers 4 Endgame is the most anticipated movie of 2019. Not for me. Glass Movie is. For me, Glass Movie, for me, is more highly anticipated than Avengers Endgame. Now, this is going to be very interesting how much this film makes. But I don't want to start boring people about box office again, because this generation talks too much about box office and not as much about the actual films, which is really disappointing. But M. Night Shyamalan, wow. This film never bores you at any element. You never think, oh, you know. And I just think this is a very important film, considering how important superheroes are right now. Now, this is a trilogy. If you like, this is kind of a type of superhero, supervillain trilogy, right? So the first one is about Bruce Willis's character, whose character's name I forgot. Then you get this supervillain story, and it's full of so much depth if you think about it. Then we're going to get the next supervillain story, which is Glass Movie. So this could run and run and run. They need to build a franchise here. This is big. This is the way they compete with DC and Marvel, Universal. This is the thing, right? This is the thing now. Is it Universal? Anyway, whoever it is, this is magic. And of course, who's part of this? Blumhouse. Jason Blumhouse Productions, one of the best little production companies going around right now. So, you know, it's the gift that keeps on giving. This is a 10 out of 10 film. As I say, the best film I have seen in the past 20 years. Simply amazing.